also friends and relatives. Just thanking you for being here today. What an awesome opportunity, a beautiful, glorious day it is today, celebrating the first ever Coast Salish Day. Give yourselves a big round of applause. We just raise our hands to you, just thanking you for being here today. And it's a great collaboration between our tribal folks and the city of Bellingham to come together like this and do some really important work. And one of the things I was listening to on the radio today, many of you might know that there's a surge of change in all across America with the changing of Columbus Day to Indigenous Peoples Day. And many cities and states and locations are rethinking the way that history is viewed in this country. And so it's just a glorious day today, and I'm just very honored to be here. My name's Michael Vendiola. I'm a Swinomish Indian Tribal Community member. I work for the state of Washington as the Director of Indian Education in the Office of the Superintendent of Public Instruction. And one of the beautiful things is that our children are going to be learning in a whole new environment as these types of changes come to happen in the community. And the state of Washington had made that commitment to teach about tribal history, culture, and government, and recently made that a requirement for public schools to teach that. So those are some of the changes. So those are some of the changes that are happening in the community that are, really a part of this movement, and forward-thinking people. And I've been honored to be a part of a movement that looked at this occasion at the 500th anniversary, the quincentennial celebration of Columbus landing in the Caribbean. And that is really when a big push came in the community in Berkeley, California. Similar to Bellingham, passed a resolution to change Columbus Day to Indigenous Peoples Day, and that was in 1992. And I was very honored to be there because we got to witness tens and thousands of people coming together to look at this issue. At that time, they're actually trying to do a reenactment of the three ships landing, except they're landing in San Francisco Bay. And we came down there and said this was not, an appropriate thing to do. And so, those types of community movements just trying to stimulate people to rethink the way that they think about history is such an important thing. And I'm really honored to be here and witness this in our community. So we're very fortunate to have the leadership on the Bellingham City Council to try to do our best as Coast Salish people and to be in this space and to honor our cultural ways as best as we can. And that's what we're going to try to do today. We say istitam sen, which is we're doing the best that we can. So we just thank you and honor, we're honored to be here. And be patient with us. So at this time, we'd like to call forward some witnesses. And I have my modern day notebook because I don't want to mess up. But if you're not familiar with our Coast Salish ways, we'd like to call forward witnesses to be a witness to the work that's being done today. And we cover the witnesses, to cover their heart, just to warm their heart, and help them to remember what happens here today. And these are the ones that will go forward and can be called upon to recall what has happened here today. So we're honored to have these people here to help us do this work. Hawhetton, if you could come forward. And we'll have you, we'll cover you. And we have a seat up here. Any of these seats, they're good view up here. But
Hawhetton,
So as witnesses, you'll be able to use Robert's Rules of Order. That's what we'll be following as witnesses. We'd like to call forward Joel Ridley, if you could come forward and be a witness for the work here today. I'd like to cover you, warm your heart, ask you to remember all that happens here today. Quashinam? Quashimat. Thanking you for stepping forward, helping us do the work here today. Pukfathat, Pukfathat. We have one of our youth representatives. We're asking him to come forward, show his leadership. It's a young one that's coming forward, really active in the community as a youth leader. At this time, we'd like to call Beth Brownfield. Beth Brownfield, asking you to come forward and be a witness here. I'd like to cover your heart, ask you to remember the work that's done here today. You may be seated. We're being ultra formal today. We'll see him. At this time, we'd like to call forward Nunsus Takai, our drum group that's here today, to offer an honoring song just to open the floor.
As an honoring song, if everybody could please
Well, Sam, you can have a seat now. It's raising our hands to our drum group. Thank you for being here, offering that song. At this time, we want to call forward one of our community leaders here in Bellingham, Mr. Terry Borneman. You can come forward, and we're very honored to have a very special announcement here today, and he's going to lead us in that work. So, thank you. I like how you do the... This is our cultural ways, the cultural exchange.
Very honored to be here today on our first Coast Salish Day. This has been a long time coming. I've had the honor over the years of working with and being friends with many members of different Coast Salish tribes. A few years ago, a person came to City Council and asked that we name a street in honor of Martin Luther King Jr. They said we didn't have a street like other cities have. And a couple weeks after this person came to the City Council, a young woman came to the City Council and said, an African-American woman, and said, you know, I don't know if that's the best idea, because the issues around civil rights that we have here have been more towards the First Nations than African-American here. And it got me thinking that she was very right. Is it more appropriate to look at naming a street after, in honor of the Coast Salish people? And so I brought it up to the council and then started working with different tribal members on different names that might possibly work. And then the idea struck me. A old mentor of mine, a wonderful, wonderful woman by the name of Imogene Bowen. She was a Upper Skagit tribal member and the first Native American to lead a county political party. She was the head of the Skagit County Democrats at one time. She had introduced me to Billy Frank Jr. and told me stories about about his exploits and the work that he had done towards Native rights, towards Native civil rights, towards tribal rights, towards fishing rights, just encompassing all of these ideas. And I got thinking, and I had met Billy along the way a couple different times. Daryl Hilaire had introduced me to him at a few different functions, and I realized this is the civil rights leader that we should be naming a street after. And so I brought it to the council. At first I talked with Roxanne, and Roxanne said, yeah, this is the right way to go. So we brought it to the city council. Our city council voted unanimously to pursue the idea of naming a street Billy Frank Jr. But first, before I brought it to the council, I was talking with Dr. Vernon Damani Johnson from Western. And Damani, when I raised that, he thought it was a great idea, but he said, what about Indian Street? That is the gateway to Western, to the university, and wouldn't that be appropriate? And then I talked to Roxanne again, yeah, that's the idea. And so we brought it to the council. The council voted unanimously to pursue the idea of renaming the street. We started the process. We had to contact all of the residents along Indian Street to see if there's problems. We had to look into a lot of ideas, but I did receive the word they're going to order the signs Billy Frank Jr. Street, and that will be becoming official in November. So I'm really proud to announce that. Yeah. And I do want to say, I think almost everyone here knows who Billy Frank Jr. is, but if you haven't, look him up. He has a tremendous history, tremendous man, and has done so much for this region. So thank you.
One more big round of applause for Terry and that announcement. We had invited the Frank family, Billy Frank's family, to be here today. Unfortunately, today there's also a Northwest Indian Fish Commission meeting, and Willie, who is the son, has stepped into Billy Frank Jr.'s spot on the Fish Commission, is trying to carry on that work. So fortunately, he wasn't here able to join us. But I'd like to invite Candace Wilson, Kotz Tanat, to come forward to say a few words. And we're asking her to just pass this news on to the family and let them know of the good work that was done here today.
Hi, Squile, Siam, Nisjalicha, Siam, Quanstanat, Senesnat. Good afternoon, friends and family. Thank you, each and every one of you, for being here today. I am Candace Wilson from Lummi Nation. I served on the Lummi Indian Business Council for 9 years and 3 years as a vice chairwoman. And I was fortunate and blessed to have the opportunity to share wonderful moments with a wonderful man named Billy Frank Jr. He was an honorable man, a true warrior in his own right. He was raised amongst great tribal leaders, such as his father himself, who provided testimony at the age of 103 to a court that knew little about who we are, but came to his home to listen to this wonderful man's story, yet to determine an appellate order 10 years later that gave the great Nisqually people their right, their inherent rights, not just treaty rights. It was about inherent rights to fish and live on their traditional territorial lands. So Billy Frank stepped into those shoes when his father had passed away, as his son is doing for him. But this is an honorable moment for the family, and on behalf of the family, we thank you, the City of Bellingham, for naming this wonderful street after him in place of Indian Street. It will now be known as Billy Frank Jr. Haishka Siam, Siam Nisjalicha. I would like to personally thank every one of you that came here today, especially our singers who answered the call to honor us with the beautiful song and voice, the family, the children, and the speakers who have stepped forward to speak and recognize and honor this day as a momentous day. It's been an honor to be a witness of changing the name of Columbus Day in the City of Bellingham to Coast Salish Day. As we sat here over a year ago, right here providing testimony to the City of Bellingham Council, where there was a packed house of citizens and students from throughout, not just Bellingham, but Whatcom County. It was a momentous moment, and will change the lives of Bellingham, the citizens in Whatcom County, and across the nation forever. So we want to thank them once again for honoring the Coast Salish people, the Lac-Tamish people of the Great Salish Sea. Haishka Siam, Siam Nisjalacha. And finally, from Billy Frank, the fight is never over. The fight for who we are and our culture and our way of life. Billy Frank Jr. Haishka Siam. Thank you.
Can we give Candace one more round of applause? Thank you. And for those of you who know Candace, she's usually a little bit more vibrant than today, but I happen to know why her voice is off a little bit. It's because she was screaming and cheering for the Lummi Blackhawks. So. And that was on Friday. Still, she's still trying to get her voice back. So, yeah. So we just thank you for honoring us and being here with saying a few words on behalf of the family, and just thank you for carrying that message back to the family and letting them know. At this time, we want to bring forward one of our other leaders here in the Bellingham City Council, doing the tremendous work here today, Roxanne Murphy. Let's give her a big round of applause.
Good morning, everyone. I come to you today with great respect for my Joe family ancestors. I also come to you today with great respect for all Coast Salish ancestors, tribal members, elders, and tribal members everywhere. I also especially want to extend respect for all of those cultures and all of those faith-based systems that have been so horrifically affected by the acts of colonization. To me, in my heart of hearts, I know that our resilience is our greatest revenge against colonization, and I believe that this day is all about resilience. Haishka. My name is Roxanne Murphy. I'm an eighth generation member of the Nooksack Indian tribe, loud and proud. And I humbly serve as your Bellingham City Council member at large. So basically, the most fundamental thing I can say is that it's one of the greatest honors of my 39.7 years of walking around Washington State to celebrate Coast Salish Day with each and every one of you. This was a dream of mine that I had since I was a young girl, you know, learning about my tribal membership and not understanding why we celebrated this man when we could celebrate culture that preceded him. So I brought this forward to the Bellingham City Council with the best of intentions, and it was so funny because there would be certain points when this was going on. I mean, this initiative received local and national media attention, and I was having dinner with my friends at one point, and they said, "Well, why is your cell phone going so crazy?" And I said, "I think that's because they said my name in the media another time." And whenever that happened, everybody felt it necessary to text message me and tell me what they thought about that. But really what I want to say is this initiative had very little to do with me. This had to do with the fact that I really wanted to show respect for all of the Coast Salish people that have always called this place home before there were municipalities, before there was a county, before there was anything of the like, and there were no borders. And so I wanted to pay respects not just to my ancestors, but all Coast Salish ancestors that have called this place home. Another reason I wanted to bring this forward is I wanted to be a part of the Abolish Columbus Day movement. It's just plain and simple. I know I bring up that national media attention because this is sweeping our nation, and I hope our state legislators are paying attention as well as the federal. So if you support this, will you please scream so they can hear us in Olympia? My last goal for this was I really hoped it would bring so many different community members together as we can all jointly learn from each other. That happened a year ago when so many people came and voiced their support for this. And then it was funny because after the city council voted for it, everybody went downstairs and they were talking and cheering so loudly we could barely hold our meeting. But that's the beauty of bringing communities together, and that's what I hope this day will always do. And lastly, I just want to say that I really hope this day will be a gift that will keep on giving. May you come to every Coast Salish Day. May it get bigger and better. And may it bring joy to every Coast Salish Day that there will be. And, you know, one more thought is that one of my mentors said, you know, you're going to see and experience things every day in Whatcom County that are going to make you so proud to be a member of the Nooksack Indian Tribe. Nothing could be more true than that today, right here, right now. But I'm also so proud to be from a city that is willing to support this. And I thank you for your support with all of my heart. Haishka Siam. Thank you.
LCM, thank you, Roxanne. Beautiful work. One more round of applause. At this time, we have some community folks that are here, folks that we want to acknowledge. At this time, we want to call forward. I see somebody in the audience, one of our new appointees to the Superior Court judge, and it would only be appropriate to have her come forward. It's also one of our native leaders in the community. Fairhaven faculty member and serving the community as a judge. So we'd really like to honor Raquel Montoya Lewis to say a few words here today. So if you have any of your parking tickets, get them out now, and we're gonna.
I don't have anything prepared to say, but I will say that I'm really glad that this is happening, and it's a real honor for me to be able to walk across the street from the courthouse and come here and walk in these doors and hear all the singers and feel like I'm home here, and that that this community embraces all of us, and it's a real honor to be able to represent the court and to represent my community and my adopted community of the Coast Salish people here who have been incredibly welcoming to me over the time that I've lived here. It's a really special thing to be able to come today to talk about Coast Salish Day and have that be the name of this day. I grew up with Columbus Day as being a holiday, and every year at this time I think about the things that I was taught about what this day meant. And then learning what it really means. So it's really special to me to be able to be here and take a break from my day over at the courthouse and come here and think that we're taking it back. And I'm really grateful to Roxanne for doing this and to Michael for inviting me to be here today. It's very special to be here. So thank you. Appreciate the time.
friends and relatives, we just thank you for being here this morning and afternoon, and acknowledging all of our friends and allies that have stood with the community with making this event happen, and we're very honored to have you here today. So many good things, good words that were shared today that talk about the empowerment of the tribal communities, and seeing ourselves reflected in the curriculum and the educational system, and a lot of things that have been left unsaid. And this day, it's a token day, but it's a reminder that there's a lot of more work to be done in the community. And we just thank you for being here and being a part of this occasion. At this time, we're going to turn the floor over to our witnesses, and they'll speak in the order that they were called. So at this time, we'll have Haheten come forward. I think you're going to sit. You're going to sit at your seat, or you can either press the button or use this.
Asiam and Estalajasiam. Sweet and Ohila Quenis and Atachla Tiakias. How Hetan, son of Snap. How Hetan, son of Snap. Chuck Willumison. On behalf of my family, I can't speak on behalf of the tribe, but on behalf of my 80% of the tribe is my family. Just want to share my heartfelt haichka. Can you guys say haichka? Haichka means thank you. Thank you to each and every one of you for taking this breadth of time, Siam, to be here with us, not only for us to be witnesses, but for you to be witnesses as well. The beautiful songs, the beautiful song, the beautiful words that were said here today comes from our Creator. The ones that came forward spoke from their heart. We are taught in our culture, when we follow our heart, there's nothing that can't go wrong. Something drew you here today, Siam. Something pulled you out of your normal schedule to be here to witness this event, witness this moment. This moment is a beautiful one because we are sharing our time together. I want to thank the little ones that are here, especially from my tribe. Haichka, thank you for bringing them here to witness this event. They may not know what's really happening, but their heart will remember it. Some of us grew up here in Whatcom County, away from the reservation. Some of us grew up with racism, Siam. Racism still exists today, and it confuses us because we don't know why we treat each other the way we do. But it's through moments like this that can help educate our young ones so that they're not raised in that way, Siam. My people are the people of the great Lummi Nation. We are the survivors of the great flood. We stand on the shoulders of our ancestors who got us to this level, Siam. We are the ones that are carrying their torch. It was them that decided that they wanted to do whatever they could to have a future for us. And that future continues to be where we have to get along with one another. We have to do things like agreements. And we say things like good faith negotiations so that we can move forward with our future together. Because nobody's going anywhere. You'll always be here, and doggone it, Lummi Nation will always be here as well. Back in 1855, our treaty was signed, and depending on who you speak to, some people think that was a great thing that we did. Others of us believe that that treaty, although the intent was to keep peace, we gave up a lot in that treaty. And our ancestors came home and knew that they were not as happy as they wanted to be for having to sign that. But here we are today, 2015, And we see things in that treaty where the United States government was trying to give us $165,000 for all of our land and all of our water. Today, that's $4.7 million. And I know our people would never, ever give up our land and our water for not any amounts of money, not especially our protecting our water, CM. We have things in our treaty. Article 13 talks about trying to make us a farming community. We're not farmers. I don't know one of my tribal members who is a farmer. Article 14. This is the most important treaty article because it talks about protecting and giving us our education, funding education, funding medicine for our people in trade of the land and in trade of this water. And our people will never, ever forget, let the U.S. government forget that, that that is their treaty obligation to this. We've overcome many obstacles. A lot of our family members were sent off to boarding schools. And it's still a part of who we are because it still hurts us. This transgenerational grief still stands with us. And it makes us feel good to sing these songs, CM, to be able to speak our language, because it is through the language, it is through education that's going to help us move forward and overcome all these obstacles. But more importantly, it's going to be through these good faith negotiations that we have here today. The late Billy Frank Jr. was a mentor of mine, and I'm very thankful that we're honoring him and his family and the work that he did for so many of us that are still here on this side. He went to jail more times than all of us in this room put together because he had held a conviction in his heart that those waters were for us to be able to fish, to be able to do whatever we had to do in those waters for generations before us. When he saw you, he would say, "Jesus Christ, how the heck are you today?" I'm a strong Catholic man. I really believe in my faith and my Creator. So I struggled with him saying that to me. But again, the intention behind that was he was so happy to see you, so ecstatic that he was there with you at this moment. So I'm glad and I'm thankful that this is the beginning, hopefully, of a generation to come, where not only do we name our streets after such prominent people in Native culture and Native history, that we do that at home as well. But we also do more than that, that we educate our children through the school. And I'm thankful that Cousin Michael and the work that the state is doing to make sure that we have education, the true education in our school books, so that the story can be told. And it might not feel good to some people in the room, but it happened. And we must acknowledge it. As Lummi people, we must acknowledge it. We must move forward and overcome those obstacles, CM. I'm thankful that today is Slaktamish Day. My mouth is dry, I can't say it right. Slaktamish Day means the people. So this might be Coast Salish Day here in the city of Bellingham. It's Slaktamish Day at home. Oh, CM and Estella, CM, my hands go out to each and every one of you. Skeno Ait, Haichka, thank you very much.
Heist got to August, no, I swallow it, dear Kaisiam. Heights at August Nook. Konanits. Look, Konanits. At a Tia Kayasia. Heights at a Nesplech. In Tayatin. Tayatin Nostalgia. Tayatin Nahuritam Kin. Tayatin. Siam Siaya. Haitka, out of the cheek, the clavijasin, it's a utatisin, it's a escapem sin. Haitka, at a lenita, na quamuch, the quamuch saleni. Haitka, at a lenita, and na quamuch, salalachla, the skein of east, siam. Pushim it on a snap. Chaklumisin. It's an Chashash Pokolaksin. The sclay and squall, the Tiakais. The sclay and squall. It's a August and squall, it's a skein of light. Just want to say a few words. In a good way, with a good heart, and a good mind. Want to thank the people for coming and gathering here today. Want to thank my relatives. Just want to thank you guys for coming and offering your strength, for coming and offering your prayers, your tiliyat, for coming and offering your one heart, your one mind for the work today. Thank you for listening to the songs. Thank you for listening to the work. Thank you for witnessing the work today. It's sacred. It's kaka and stipe. It's sacred work. Thank you for acknowledging my people, for the feelings of my people, acknowledging our existence. Our hands go up to you. But a good heart and a good mind. I don't know the Lummi language, but I'm learning it and I'm doing the best I can. I'm a survivor of the Great Flood. My people were survivors of the Great Flood. We're from Lummi. It's a Klaptamish. Klaptamish Tamuch. That's our territory. We're people of the sea. I just wanted to thank you. I say this with a good heart and a good mind. My ancestral name is Kwashime. Just wanted to say a few words. I want to share the Chasin so that you guys know that our language still is alive. In my home, we speak our language. With my brother, when we call each other, we greet each other in the language. We tell each other we love each other in the language. Our culture is alive. Our people are alive. Our language is alive. We practice it every day. It's not something we take off and hang up. So it feels good to be acknowledged. Speaking on behalf of my family, I just wanted to say thank you. This is such a heartfelt and such an uplifting day for our people. No need to get into details of what had happened. It just feels good knowing that our people are finally being lifted up. Being lifted up in such a way to be acknowledged. There's no words that can be spoken, no words that can be shared to express how we feel. There's no words to describe the feelings, the chachnin that we get. my auntie was saying. She quoted Billy Frank Jr., "The fight will never stop. The fight will never stop for our people. We're always going to be standing in that front line for our rights, whether it be fishing, for tribal gaming, whatever it may be, to preserve, to protect, promote, and preserve our stalagmi. We sincerely raise our hands to you guys for coming and standing next to us and helping us along our way. We say thank you so much. Our people have been here for thousands of years. For thousands of years. Not one or two, but thousands of years. Our people have fished in this tunnel. We have hunted in this tunnel for thousands of years. We have remains that are predated 5, 10, 5, 6,000 years old. Just to shed a little bit of light. So we thank you once again for the acknowledgement. We thank you for your support. It means so much to my people and I. It means so much to us to sit here with the up and coming. It feels so good to have my children here.
Ichu Isle I Quanisi Lamnama Tomoksoi Antha Pakwithit. Hello, it is good to see you all. My name is Pakwithit. My parents are Lana and Joseph Johnson.
Is this one better?
And my va hold on.
What's on?
It's on. And my biological father is the late Gordon Seymour. First of all, my hands go up to my elders and those who have given me the opportunity to speak and to witness the Coast Salish Day. It's a really big honor being my age and upcoming, as the speakers before me have said. My name is Hamilton Seymour, and the traditional name I carry is from my great-great-great-grandfather on my late father's side. I'm enrolled in a Nooksack Indian tribal member, and I'm also very honored to come from Swinomish Tribe and Vancouver Island, Chemainus First Nation. I'm only 16 years old and a junior at Mount Baker High School currently. Although I didn't know Billy Frank Jr., I know that he fought for our fishing rights and for sovereignty. I read he was arrested more than 50 times in the fish wars that were in the 1960s because of his intense dedication to the Treaty of Fishing Rights cause. It is because of such leaders as Billy Frank Jr., my family, my peers, and my tribal leaders, who have inspired me to honor and represent our ancestors and where I come from. For it is our ancestors that have instilled our culture and traditions that we will work together and carry on and pass down to our future generations and to the upcoming ones. Although I'm very quite humbled and I take great pride of our leadership roles that I've been both encouraged to lead and ultimately elected, there are many challenges youth are facing: addiction, chronic health diseases, and preventable issues such as suicide. But in all the hardship and tragedy, opportunities to be leaders have empowered youth to fight these that have empowered the youth to fight for our future and for ourselves and our people. I've been blessed to work alongside with others who strive and have hope for healthy communities. I represent my youth as the vice chair of the Nooksack Community and Tribal Youth Council. That role has led me to service not only my fellow tribal members, but the youth as well that combat the same challenges. My year-long term as the Northwest Area Regional Representative for the Unity Executive Committee that has recently ended, I continue to carry on the mission of Unity, which is to help youth mentally, physically, spiritually, and emotionally. I'm one of the Native youth from across the nation that was selected as the 2015 Champion for Change, which is sponsored by the Center for Native American Youth. This award recognizes youth who are making a difference in their communities. As a Champion for Change, we discuss topics that are usually hard for adults or kids my age that feel uncomfortable to talk about, such as sexual abuse and suicide. As a Native youth leader, we're tackling these issues head on. My application for the award focused on keeping culture alive through traditional sports and positive mental health. I chose war canoe racing as my health initiative to make a change for health and wellness, including youth suicide prevention, bereavement, and grief, and healing practices for promotion of substance and alcohol abuse prevention. In February 2015, I got to attend the Champions for Change recognition event, of which I, the four other youth, were honored to carry out Senator Byron Dorgan's vision of spotlighting youth who are making a difference in their communities. I was able to share my own vision of leadership and the impact to learn about the national work being done in Indian Country. This was my first opportunity to discuss and to share my story of positive youth-led efforts and the spread of my story of leadership focusing on suicide prevention. I was also recently selected by the Portland Area Indian Health Board as an ambassador for the We Are Native program. It's a networking program for Native youth by Native youth, and we're meant to create positive change in our communities by promoting positive health behaviors, hosting events in our communities, and traveling to different events to represent We Are Native. As an ambassador, I will create awareness of suicide prevention to carry out my Champions for Change initiative. Sadly, suicide has affected me personally. As my, I lost my father to suicide in 2012. My dad was a phenomenal man, and I'd just like to carry out his name through his spirit, through paddling my health initiative. I feel like paddling is one of the few things I have left of him. It was the grace of canoe paddling and the team companionship and support that has helped me and my family, and I become resilient at practicing the teachings of our elders and living our culture through the canoe way of life. Through my travels, I've made a lot of connections and have been told I've touched the hearts of many. My initiative to prevent the use of drugs and alcohol, and my initiative to prevent the use of drugs and alcohol and suicide through war canoe paddling is being fulfilled as we speak. This opportunity has brought so many people together who share the same passion for the canoe and find the same healing through the water. I'm only 16 years old, and last year I would have never imagined myself being an advocate for Native youth my age and older. I'm just one Native youth who has a desire to make a difference in my community, and I know you all feel the same. Imagine as we come together, our strength in numbers signifies the strength of our people. I'd like to thank you for this opportunity to be included in this historical event. I look forward to continuing to learn from my elders and carrying out the culture and traditions through my initiative of using war canoe paddling to heal our community. Thank you. Aishka.
My name is Beth Brownfield, and I'm honored and moved to be asked to witness. As far as I'm concerned, I think every day should be Lochtimish Day, Coast Salish Day. And I feel your ancestors here today, from time immemorial, that are here. And I think it's important that in our congregations, in our meetings, that we do that whenever we meet, that we acknowledge the people that have been here since time immemorial. When I was 12, I read something in a textbook in my sixth grade class. I can remember the desk that I was sitting in, a wooden top with an inkwell and a lift-up top you could put your books in. And I had read about smallpox blankets. And I could not believe that anyone could do anything to another person in order to infect them with the disease that would kill them. And I thought it was because we didn't know any better then. And I didn't know what to do with that thought or those feelings that opened my heart, broke my heart at age 12. And I think today, as we put on these blankets that are given to us in love and acknowledgement, that it's very important in that aspect. And as a witness, I have only been in this state since 2004. And I met Daryl Hilaire and Jewel James in Albuquerque before I moved here, and they were talking about the totem pole, and I said, I'm moving to Bellingham and I hope to be a good neighbor. And so I moved here, and I met Aaron. I had been involved in activism and indigenous issues in Minneapolis, and I wanted to, there were so many people here that didn't know anything about Coast Salish culture or anything, and I wanted to facilitate classes with people from Lummi and Nooksack, so I came to talk to Daryl Hilaire, and Daryl moved me right across the hall to Aaron, who was his assistant, to ask permission to do those courses, but using people from Lummi and Nooksack. So that's when I first met Aaron, who gave me a whole list of people who became my friends, and we had, you know, 4 or 5, 6 years of classes where people, you know, filled up the classes they wanted to know. And then I went out to Nooksack and talked to George Adams and asked permission to do that there. Who is this white woman coming in and teaching about Coast Salish culture? I knew about Plains, you know, culture, but not enough even to teach it. And here, not even Coast Salish culture. So I had the privilege of meeting so many people there. So I have seen so many things happen. I mean, to hear Michael talk about the curriculum that is going to be mandated in the schools, that our the children, all children will learn about their culture and history and be proud of that. And renaming Indian Street Billy Frank Jr. Street. I knew Billy Frank, and he would do the same thing. Whenever he saw you, he'd give you a big hug and just be so glad to see you. And then the canoe journey that's happened, the revival of Coast Salish culture through the canoe journeys and the music. I mean, when I come in and hear the drums and the singing, it just goes deep inside my heart. And then all of the things that have happened with Nooksack and Lummi, as far as leadership coming forward and leading with the youth going forth. And then also, just it seems like people are more interested. They come to things. We're working together on political issues of climate change and things that would harm our environment. And so just coming together like this is so important. And I believe Coast Salish Day or Indigenous Peoples Day is going to spread. It's pretty soon it's going to be every city and county and state that will have a Coast Salish Day to honor the first original peoples and nations. So I I love this. I love that people are here. I know there's a huge group at Whatcom Community College. There's going to be Northwest Indian College this afternoon. Things are happening at Western Washington, and then also tonight at Lummi, a dinner for the community. So I just honor all of you who are here, and I just think that this is going to continue and get bigger. So thank you.
Yeah.
Friends and relatives, our work is done here today. Just thanking all of our witnesses. We'll have a closing song from our drum group. Thanking Roxanne Murphy for the hard work she put in to make this event happen.
Well, this concludes our event, and I just wanted to offer one parting thought. I am so excited to think that every future generation is going to ask, instead of what's an Indian, mom and dad, they're going to ask, who is Billy Frank Jr.? So I hope you all will just please have a very happy Coast Salish day. And again, thank you so much for being here.